Good afternoon, students. Today I am going to show you or discuss you about an example based on break and continue and while and do while. So you can see here is an example of a for loop. So where the initial I value is 1 and it's end with less than 10 and I plus plus. You can see if condition is there, which is I mod 5 equal to 0, then break and then printf to print the value of I. The output is the particular code is 1, 2, 3, 4, y. Because in case of break statement, we know when a condition, when we put break statement after a particular condition and when the condition met, then the loop will be executed. It will not get back to the for loop again. So that's why when the I value is 1, it is not divisible by 5. That's why the output will be 1. Again, I will be incremented by 1, then the value will be 2. 2 is again not divisible by 5, so the 2 will be executed. Then 3 and 4. But when the I value will be 5, it is always executed by 5. Also, it is always divisible by 5. That's why the break statement will break the loop. Okay. So after the value of 4, the I value will never be executed. So the number of loop it will execute for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, total 5 times the loop will be executed, but the value will be printed for up to 4, because you can see the printf statement is after break statement, not before break statement. If we get the printf statement before break statement, then the 5 value will be executed. Okay, so as the printf value statement is after the break statement, that's why the output will be up to 1 to 4. But in case of continue statement, you can see the value of 5 is not there in the output values. It is up to 1 to 9. Why? Because in case of continue statement, we know the when the value, when the condition will meet, then the continue statement will discard that particular condition and then again it will execute the rest of the values. So that's why I equal to 1 is not modulus or the divisible by 5. That's why 1 will be executed. Then 2, 3, 4, all the values will be executed. But if I mod 5 equal to 0, that means when the I value will be 5, it is always divisible by 5. So the 5 value will not be printed as an output value. But again, it will execute from 6 to 9. So this is the basic concept of the continue, and this is the difference between break and continue. When the condition meet for break statement, when the condition will meet, the break statement will break the loop chain and it will never get back to the for loop. But in case of continue, it will only break that particular condition chain. After that, for the next value, it will again get back to the for loop. So this is the concept of break and continue statement. Now, I'm going to show you the examples and differences between while and do while. We know while loop is always known as the entry control loop, whereas do while is always known for the exit control loop. So in this example, you can see I is initialized as 0 while I greater than 0. As 0 is never get greater than 0, because 0 is equal to 0, not greater than 0. So that's why it is entry control loop and the condition is not satisfied. That's why we will never get any output from this piece of code. So that's why the output statement is no output. But in case of do while, int I equal to 0, do printf percentage d comma I and I plus plus, we will get some value. If we print the value, we'll get the I value first 0 and then it will increment, because 1, 2, 3, all the values are greater than 0. It will be represented as a infinite loop. But if we put any such condition which is not met, like if I put I equal to 0 and while I less than 0 in case of do while loop, whatever the value is true or false, the do while loop always execute at least for once. Okay, so this is the concept and this is the difference between while and do while. That is, while loop is entry control loop. So if the condition is not true, it will never execute any loop. But in case of do while, whether the condition is true or false, the loop will be executed for once at least, because it in entry section we get a printf statement or some functional calculation part. Then in exit section, we are getting some condition checking. So for sure, if there are any false value is present in the while loop, it will execute at least for once for that false value. And for the next execution part, it will block the codes or the breach of the code if the while condition is not met. Okay, so this is the concept of while and do while. While is an entry control loop and do while is an exit control loop. And this is the example of break and continue, where if the condition is met in the break statement, the control of the loop will never get back to the for or while, any type of loop condition. And in case of continue, the if the condition is met before the continue statement, the continue statement will block that particular condition, and again it will get back to the for or while loop to execute the rest of the parts. Okay, I think it will help you to understand the concept of break and continue and the concept of while and do while. Thank you.